Hi everyone, it's Vicky here with a fun event this week. I am featuring Penny Black, so I will be posting 5 videos in 5 days. The clear stamp set that I'll be using is called Winter Joy, and I am going to use the flower. So first of all, I'm starting by working on a piece of white cardstock, and that's heavy cardstock by Simon's Stamp, and I'm blending some color on it, that's old paper. Today I'm going for a vintage look. So once I'm happy with the application of the first layer, I'm now going to mix a second color just to make it a little bit brighter and more warm. So that's wild honey. I am mainly focusing on the edges, and now I will go back with the first color all over it just to make sure that it's nicely blend and it's not as bright as it was in the beginning. To add some interest on the background, I'm going to use this stamp, which is a script stamp by Penny Black, and I'm going to apply some distressing. Now I will use Vintage Photo, which is slightly darker than my card base, and I'm not going for a perfect stamping here, I just want to have something in the background. And that's why I didn't use a stamping block. To finish off my panel, I'm going to add a little bit of distress ink on the edges, that's Vintage Photo, and that touch is going to bring everything together, the stamping at the center, along with the colors at the background. So now I'm going to stamp my flower, and I'm using my Misty tool. So I am going to decide where I want the flower to be, and I'm going to stamp it with brown ink. Now at this stage I'm using distress ink Vintage Photo, and I'm not very careful about the stamping, I just want to have a general idea of where my poinsettia is going to stay. So now I'm going to stamp it 3 different times. So that's one, and I'm using archival ink just to make sure that this is not going to smudge and I have a nice impression. And I'm just stamping the flower in white paper. Now the idea today is to create a paper pieced flower so I can add dimension, which means that I am going to color all 3 of those images and then cut out petals in different layers so I can stack them up one on top of the other. You will see what I mean. So first of all, I am going to decide which of the petals are going to be green. I will do all the coloring with my distress inks. So for the leaves I'm using 2 colors, a lighter and a darker one, and you can see on screen all the colors that I have used. And I will do the same thing for the petals, so I will use 2 shades of red. And notice how I don't really care if I go outside of the lines or even if I color other petals, because I will be using my scissors to cut out, and also I will be stacking layers one on top of the other, so it's going to cover up all the mess. I really love this technique of coloring with my finger dabbers because I find it very easy and it's really quick. Also notice how I didn't bother to cut out the whole flower, I'm just mainly focusing on the leaves. I used my finger dabber on the edges to get rid of that white edge, and now I'm going to do the exact same technique on the rest of the flowers by using red shades of distress ink. So once I have cut out everything, it was time to assemble the flower on top of my panel. Now I'm going to keep it real and I'm going to show you the mistake I did and how I saved it. So first I'm going to stick the leaves down, and I was lucky enough because that glue was quite forgiving, And then I'm going to build the flower one layer on top of the other. I am using foam squares in between just to add a little bit of dimension. So that's the first layer. Trying to position it correctly. And now I'm going to add the second layer. Now that flower is going to look beautiful and dimensional and really full, but I didn't like that I could still see underneath the flowers the stamped lines. I am going to show you what I mean. So to save that, I went ahead and stamped the flower one more time, colored it completely red, and I was able to peel off the flower from my panel and stick it down again. I am going to show you now how I saved it. So I have peeled off the flower. I have another flower that I have is totally flat, and I have colored it with red. And I'm going to apply some tape adhesive at the back and stick it directly on top of my panel. So this way I have covered up the stamping. So if you are going to replicate this card, either don't stamp the flower at all on the base, or just stamp only the stem. So now I'm able to stick that on top of that. And the good thing about that is that now my flower looks even fuller. For my sentiment, I'm going to use these dies by Penny Black, and they say joy, peace, and greetings. I decided to go with peace that I have cut out of dark chocolate cardstock, and now I'm using Nouveau Embellishment in gold color, and with my finger I'm just applying a little bit of gold. Now this is quite transparent, it's not going to cover up the color of the cardstock, but it's going to give a beautiful shine. So now I'm going to use my glue pen at the back, add a little bit of glue so that I can stick it on top of my panel. As always, you can find a full list of all the supplies that I'm using just below the video in the description area, as well as on my blog. So now my sentiment is in place, and I am going to add a little bit of that gold mousse on my flower too. I think that adding touches of gold here and there on a vintage looking card is a great touch, because it really makes it look authentic. For my card base, I'm going to use dark chocolate cardstock that I have folded, and that's a top folding card that's 4.25 by 5.5. But for the border, I'm going to do the same technique with my finger. I'm going to apply a little bit of that Nouveau Embellishment mousse. Once I have all the border nice and gold, I'm going to stick my panel at the center of my card base. I'm just using some tape adhesive there. To finish it off, I'm going to use Nouveau Crystal Drops, and I will use the bright gold at the center of the flower. Now this is where I made a mistake. I made the dots too big, so they will become one. And this really bothered me, I just couldn't look at it. So I managed to scrape everything off with my spatula, and you will see here that they look nice and perfect. So that was the card for today. I hope you had fun and got inspired. And if you did, don't forget to leave me a comment, as well as give me thumbs up on my YouTube channel. Don't forget to visit me tomorrow for another video.